Good day, class. Welcome to another edition of Scholars University Secondary School online chemistry class. I am Solomon, your online chemistry teacher. Today, we'll be discussing nitrogen and its compound. Now, under nitrogen and its compound, we're going to discuss its occurrence in nature, electronic configuration, laboratory preparation, and industrial preparation. Talk about its physical and chemical properties. Then we'll talk about some uses of nitrogen gas and some important compound of nitrogen. For example, we are going to talk about the ammonia gas, the trazonitrite-5 acid, and the trazonitrite-5 salt. Now, nitrogen occurs as a free element in air and occupies 78% of the total volume of air. Now, due to the presence of nitrogen in air, the rates of combustion, respiration, and corrosion are reasonably slow. Now, that's why we refer to nitrogen as the diluent constituent of air. The diluent constituent of air. Now, nitrogen occurs in its combined form as salts of trazonitrite-5 of sodium and calcium, which occur abundantly in the Earth's crust. It also occurs in its combined state in ammonium salts and also in organic matter like in proteins, urea, and vitamin B compounds. As to the electronic configuration of nitrogen has atomic number of 7 and mass number of 14. An electronic configuration of 1s2, 2s2, and 2p3. Now, from this electronic configuration, you can see that nitrogen has 5 valence electrons. Now, this is the atomic structure of nitrogen. And when we count the number of valence electrons, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, you can see that it has 5 valence electrons. And let's confirm this from this electronic configuration. The 2s and the 2p are the outermost shell, are the orbital in the outermost shell of the atomic structure of nitrogen. Now, when we add the number of electrons present, we have the 2 electrons for the 2s and the 3 electrons for the 2p. Now, 2 plus 3 gives us 5, which conform to this structure that we have here for nitrogen. Now, this means that nitrogen requires 3 electrons to attain the octet structure of the noble gases. Now, you can see that from this atomic structure. Nitrogen just requires only 3 electrons to attain the octet structure of the noble gases. And it does this by undergoing electrovalence combination, which is also known as the ionic combination with metals, and also covalence combination with non-metals, and also covalence combination with itself. That means with another of the atom, a nitrogen atom combining with another nitrogen atom to form the nitrogen molecule in form of nitrogen gas. Now, to the laboratory preparation of nitrogen. Nitrogen can be prepared in the laboratory using various methods, but the first method or the first reagent we use, which is the commonly used one in the lab, that we're going to talk about is ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt. That means the preparation of nitrogen from ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt. And nitrogen is obtained by the thermal decomposition of ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt. But the ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt is not heated directly because the reaction is vigorous and can get out of control. The ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt is thus prepared by heating the mixture of sodium trazonitrite-3 salt and ammonium chloride, which are in the ratio 7 to 5. Please let's take note of this ratio between the sodium trazonitrite-3 salt and ammonium chloride salt. Now, the ammonium trazonitrite-3 salts produced readily decompose to form nitrogen gas and also to form steam. Now, this sodium trazonitrite-3 salt reacting with ammonium chloride, forming the ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt and the sodium chloride. Now, this ammonium trazonitrite-3 salt is heated and it releases the nitrogen gas and also water in form of steam. Now, to the next one I'm going to discuss is the preparation of nitrogen from ammonium heptadichromate 6. Nitrogen can be prepared by the decomposition of ammonium heptadichromate 6 because the ammonium heptadichromate 6 decomposes readily to produce nitrogen. And this is the equation of the reaction. And this is ammonium heptadichromate 6, as you can see, forming the nitrogen gas and an oxide of chromium and some water molecule. Now, we can also prepare nitrogen from ammonia. Now, when we prepare nitrogen from ammonia by oxidizing the ammonia to form nitrogen. And we oxidize the ammonia using hot copper 2 oxide. That means The ammonia serves as the reducing agent, while the hot copper two oxide serves as the oxidizing agent. Now this is the equation of the reaction. You can see that this is the ammonia gas reacting with the copper two oxide to liberate nitrogen gas and also form deposit of copper, and some water molecule is also formed with it. Now you can see that the copper is reduced. The copper oxide is reduced from 2 plus to 0. When you calculate the oxidation number of copper here, you calculate it will be 2 plus, but here you have it as 0. And nitrogen here, the oxidation number of nitrogen is from minus 3 here to 0, which shows that the oxidation number of nitrogen and ammonia has increased from minus 3 to 0. So ammonia is the reducing agent, while hot copper 2 oxide is the oxidizing agent. Now, the last one we are going to be discussing in the laboratory preparation of nitrogen is the preparation of nitrogen from dinitrogen 1 oxide. Now, dinitrogen 1 oxide is also known as the laughing gas. Now, nitrogen can be prepared from dinitrogen 1 oxide gas when it is made to react with hot copper tonnage. Now, the copper tonnage reduce the dinitrogen 1 oxide to nitrogen gas, while the copper it is oxidized to copper 2 oxide. Now, this is the equation of the reaction. This is the dinitrogen 1 oxide gas being reduced by this copper to form the nitrogen gas, and copper 2 oxide is also formed in the process. Now, to the industrial preparation of nitrogen. Nitrogen is prepared from air for industrial uses. Now, we prepare nitrogen by passing a stream of air through a beaker containing caustic soda to remove the carbon dioxide present in the air mixture. Now, the remaining air mixture is then passed into concentrated tetrahydrosulfate citric acid in order to remove the water vapor present in the air. And the remaining air is heated in iron tube containing copper tonnage in order to remove the oxygen present in the air mixture, leaving the nitrogen gas and the noble gases. Now, this is the diagram showing the industrial preparation of nitrogen. As you can see, we have air here. Now, the air in this beaker is being displaced by the water added through this pipe. Now, the air continues journey and move through this pipe into this beaker containing caustic soda, and we have sodium hydroxide as an example of caustic soda here. Now, the sodium hydroxide solution, which serves as the caustic soda, absorb all the carbon dioxide present in the air mixture that is coming from this beaker here. Then, after the carbon dioxide has been absorbed, the remaining air mixture continues its journey into this furnace, into this iron furnace containing copper tonnage, in order to remove the oxygen present in the remaining air. Now, the remaining air is then passed through this region, is collected at this region over water. Now, the remaining air is just nitrogen gas and the noble gases. Now, please take note that nitrogen is collected over water because it is not soluble in water, or it is slightly soluble in water, as we see in its physical properties. And to the physical properties of nitrogen, nitrogen is a colorless, tasteless, and odorless diatomic gas. That means nitrogen occurs as a diatomic gas as N2. Now, nitrogen is slightly lighter than air. That means it is not heavier than air. It is slightly lighter than air. Its weight is closer to air, but not heavier than air. And it's also slightly soluble in water. It has a melting point of minus 210 degrees Celsius and a boiling point of minus 196 degrees Celsius. So it's chemical properties. Now, due to its high bond energy, nitrogen tends to be inert. That means it tends to be unreactive, or react with metals, hydrogen and oxygen at elevated condition. That means at high temperature and pressure, and probably in the presence of catalyst. Now, the reaction with metal. Nitrogen combines directly with electropositive metal like sodium, magnesium, calcium, potassium, when heated to form nitride. Now, for example, this is magnesium reacting with nitrogen gas to form the magnesium nitride, Mg3N2. Now, this nitride can be hydrolyzed readily with warm water to release ammonia gas. Now, this is the magnesium nitride reacting with the water molecule to form the magnesium hydroxide and releasing ammonia gas. Now, reaction with non-metals. Nitrogen combined with hydrogen to release ammonia gas or to form ammonia gas. And this is the nitrogen gas combining with the hydrogen gas to form the ammonia gas. Please take note that this equation is not balanced. Let's take note of that. Now, nitrogen also reacts with oxygen to release nitrogen 2 oxide. Now, this is nitrogen gas reacting with oxygen to form the nitrogen 2 oxide. Now, to the uses of nitrogen. Nitrogen is used for the production of ammonia, which is an important chemical in the laboratory and also in the industry. And it's also used to produce cyanide and carbamide. These are just few compounds that we can use nitrogen to prepare. We have other compounds. I told you nitrogen occur in proteins initially. And also we use nitrogen to prepare urea in the laboratory. Also have other important uses of nitrogen. Now, liquid nitrogen is used as a cooling agent. Also, nitrogen provides inert atmosphere. We said earlier on in the chemical property that due to its high bond energy, nitrogen tends to be inactive. So it is used as preservative of food, of packaged food, to prevent rancidity. And rancidity is just when something gets spoiled. I hope you understand it like that. Now, this is the assignment for today's lecture. I've come to the end of our class, our lecture for today. Hope to see you in the next edition of Scholars University Secondary School online class. Thank you.